ジャズの真髄に触れるなら絶対ここバーボンストリート。老舗のライブハウスに入るもよし、ストリートのビートに身を任せるのもよし。体にリズムが乗り移ってきたら、ジャズメンの素顔をもっと知りたくなってきましたね。そこでフレンチクォーターの一角にあるアパートを訪ねます。バーボンストリートではバンジョープレイヤーのトニーさんですが、本職は絵描きさん。昼間はたっぷりと日の差すリビング兼アトリエで創作に励みます。絵と音楽を愛するトニーさん、その生活はとても自由にあふれているように感じられます。
So being a street musician in New Orleans has its ups and downs, and but to be honest, I could never dream of making a living being a New Orleans street musician, simply for the fact that one does not make much money doing it.
夕方、バンジョー一つ下げた彼がまず向かうのはムーンウォークという場所です。この一見殺風景な河原が、実はミシシッピー川を行き来する船を見る人気の観光スポット。ここで相棒のジョーさんと打ち合ってファーストステージとなるのです。お客さんの集まり具合を見ながら、ここで1時間から2時間くらい、太陽がすっかり沈むまでにファーストステージは打ち切って、夜の到来とともにいざバーボンストリートへ出陣となります。
For me, it's more entertainment as I watch the people go by, people from all walks of life, people from all around the world who come to New Orleans. And I'm as curious about them as they are about me. And yes, I get a few dollars, but maybe on a good day or a good evening, if we played, let's say, 3 hours or so, we would be lucky if we got maybe $20 or $30 a man, which, as you know, in Tokyo doesn't buy much. So I do it as an extension of my creative life.
And a lot of guys that are playing in the street, the bands are taken from here and brought to Europe, and they make plenty of money. The Europeans and abroad pay a lot of money to hear this, that they hear in the street here for free. And that's why I do it. I'm a part of this culture, and that's why I like doing it.
So on two songs, I made $111. I made it $1, then a $10, then a $100. He took me home, all the whiskey I could drink, and his daughter tried to get fresh with me, but I didn't want, she was too young. So, but I could have got the whole thing. Very good. But you see, there's a lot of temptation out here, and if it's too young, you get in trouble, like anything else. So I just play music.